Hello friends and welcome back to Generation Pixel. And today, well, we're going to answer those questions. That's right, the questions I asked you to ask me to celebrate my 100 subscribers. Now, this was an opportunity for you to ask all the deep and personal questions you could think of that you wanted me to answer. But did you? Or did you just all ask silly questions like, which way do I hang my toilet paper on the wall? Well, to find out, let's roll those titles. Okay folks, let's get this show on the road. I'm going to do these questions in no particular order, but I'm going to start with one that's, well, fairly relevant at least. And it comes from two different content creators. Lightsaber Samurai and Ginger Hippie Gaming 42 both have the same question, and that is what inspired me or got me started on YouTube. And the simple answer to that question is this guy here, my eldest and only son, who decided he'd like to do a YouTube channel with me. Unfortunately, his inspiration waned where mine only grew. So thank you very much, Faded Hunter, for starting me on my path on YouTube. The next question comes from Mr. Graham Cassidy, who asks, is there a game on the current gen consoles that you would like to see a retro style version made? We are in a time of remasters and remakes, improving things like graphics and gameplay. Just wondering what you think would be fun going the other way. So for me, there's only one answer to that question, and that would be Assassin's Creed. I would love to take Altair, Ezio and Edward Kenway back in time to the 8-bit era, where they could be beautiful pixelated characters, but still able to carry out their stealth missions in style. You may have noticed I didn't include a certain Connor in that answer, and there's a simple reason for that, because Connor sucks. Now of course there were a few content creators out there who decided to ask me more than one question, and the first was Zach the All-Round Gamer, and he asked firstly, if I could collab with any YouTuber, big or small, who would it be? Now I did take a little bit of time thinking this over, because there are a few fabulous creators out there, both big and small. But at the end of the day, I came to a very strong conclusion that I would love to work with LGR. And why? Because he lives in the 90s, just like me. And the second question that Zach the All-Round Gamer asked was, which console would you have for the rest of your life? Now I'm only going to assume here that he means if I could only have one console for the rest of my life. And the answer to that is again quite simple. I would choose the 60GB backwards compatible PlayStation 3 so I could play PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2 and PlayStation 3 games. That's a no-brainer. Question 4 comes from Trick Wallace, my go-to Nintendo indie guy, or Nindy guy as he likes to call himself, and he asks the question, do you own a kilt? Well, I'm afraid to say that stereotypically so, I do, as a Scotsman, own a kilt. And here's some photographic evidence to prove so. Question number 5 comes from Gamer Stranded, another fantastic creator who doesn't get enough love, so if you're watching this, pop along to his channel, check him out, and hopefully you'll subscribe and love him just as much as me. But his question again is a little bit off topic of YouTube in general, and asks, what kind of bear is best? Well, for me there was only one answer to this, and that is a drop bear. And for anyone who doesn't know what the drop bear is, it's a terrifying animal that lives in both Australian folklore and Terry Pratchett books. And if a bear can't scare the pants off you, it's no good to anyone, so the drop bear. Question number 6 comes from Blue Neptune Gaming, one of my very first subscribers, and she asks the simple question, would you give a coyote a piggyback ride? Well, my answer to this is no, but I would certainly ride one into battle. Question number 7 comes from Watty Gaming, and it's another reasonable question and not a ridiculous one like some of the previous ones. And that question is quite simply, what's your favourite hobby not related to gaming? Well, if you cast your mind way back 6 months ago to my initial videos, you would probably see to my right hand side a selection of items that could indicate what my other hobbies are. So, take a guess for yourself, folks.
Well, Looks like we got ourselves a reader.
Question number 8 comes from Fish Eyes, and Fish Eyes asks, what is it about Final Fantasy VIII that makes it your favourite game? Well, let me tell you, when you absolutely, positively have to play as the most handsome guy in the room, well, no, you play as this guy here, Cloud Strife, Final Fantasy VIII indeed. I mean, oh, Fish Eyes, you know better, you know much better. Anyway, question number 9 comes from Flackintosh. And if you enjoy watching grown-ass men jump scared out of their lives, this is a guy to watch, so go and check him out after this video too. Anyway, Flackintosh asks, at what age did you teach your son how to play video games? Well, I'll be frankly honest here, from the moment he could hold an unplugged controller in his hand, he was sitting by my side and pretending he was playing. So, you're talking about 1, maybe 1.5 years of age. And thankfully, he still caught the bug and plays hardcore today, even as a surly teenager. Moving on to question number 10, and that comes from the Jolly Northerner, who asks, I'm curious, what is your all-time favourite game on any console? Now to this I'm going to answer, don't be ridiculous, no one has an all-time favourite game on any console. We love all games equally, and I won't hear anyone say anything else. But secondly, he asks, what's your favourite from old generation consoles? Well, to be frankly honest, I didn't play old generation consoles because I never owned any. I was an 8-bit micro boy, so I would have to slot the ZX Spectrum into this. Question number 11 comes from LikelyRapper2, and he asks, as a content creator, how do you keep yourself motivated, and what helps you to continue? Well, quite simply, I enjoy what I do on YouTube, and more importantly, I enjoy editing and learning about the editing process, so that pretty much keeps me well motivated. But if there's one other thing, and one quite important other thing, I'll let someone else a bit more qualified to explain it to you. Take it away, Backpack.
And don't forget to leave a like. It is the fire that keeps the flame fueling. And don't forget to subscribe. It's trendy, it's hip, it's hot, it's in.
Question number 12 is brought to us by the wonderfully named Plupachup. And Plupachup asks, will we ever see a full generation pixel Let's Play series on one of your favourite games? Well, I'm afraid the answer to that is probably not. And not for any other reason than my favourite games tend to be extremely long-winded, grindy JRPG games. Now, I know Brew United has pulled off a spectacular feat with Suikoden and has moved on to Suikoden 2, but I'm not sure I've got the patience for that, so... Sorry, Plupachup, doesn't look like you'll be getting any sort of long play Let's Play from me. Now, I'd like to say that I'm moving on to question 13 here, but in actuality, I'm moving on to questions 13A through 13D because Backpack's Comics has way too much energy and has too many questions, but I'll do my best to answer them, and the questions are as follows. What is your favourite anime? Well, for me at the moment, it's probably Steins Gate. What is your favourite video game? I don't have a single video game, there's too many. Now, if you ask me for a top 10 of each console of each generation, then possibly I could give you an answer. Thirdly, if you could be an animal for one day, what mischief would you cause? Well, I think I'd have to choose to be a T-Rex and just walk along a street, peering into windows, causing all sorts of chaos. And finally, lowering the tone as only Backpack Comics can, he asks, if you could poop chocolate, how would you live your life differently? Well, quite possibly I wouldn't use one of these, and I'd start pooping into Tupperware. Question 14, the penultimate question, we have Jordy Slasher Gaming, and he asks, are you the new Dominic Diamond? Well, to answer that, I'm going to have to run a little VT first, because you see, some of my subscribers, and especially most of them who have sent in questions, don't really live in the UK, so this is for them.
So, if you've ever dazzled your local arcade inhabitants with your hard-driving prowess, or simply enjoyed a waggle of your joystick in the privacy of your own bedroom, this is the show you've been gagging for.
And if you take that back to Edgware with you, and you can put it in your hand and walk proud and erect through the high street. Thank you very much, Daniel Blake.
And now it's time for me to don my smoking jacket and have a refreshing cup of chamomile. So I'll see you again in 7 days. Good night.
And to answer the question, well, I'll leave it up to you. Am I the new Dominic Diamond? Answers below. Now for the 15th and final question, it comes from Brew United, who asks, If you had to have takeout dinner tonight, what would you have? Now, because not a lot of people outside of the west of Scotland will recognise this dish, what I'm going to do is throw together a little presentation and show you exactly what I would have for takeout tonight. What can I say? You certainly can't beat a good pizza crunch. And I know Bruce only asking because he spent some time in the west of Scotland and he probably misses all the fine cuisine that we have over here. But anyway, that brings us to the end of this Q&A special. So thanks again for subscribing, thanks again for watching, and if you've enjoyed this, please hit a like, and if you've got any other questions, fire them down below. I'm always here and I'm always going to answer them. And of course, if you want to see more, feel free to hit that subscribe button. But until next time, and who knows how many subscribers that'll be, thank you again for watching and bye!